Well, I hope you all are doing well. I am Sakshi Priya, HR Manager at AirTuS Aviation Private Limited Company, welcomes you all. Today, we all are gathered here for a productive webinar, and the topic of today's webinar is Chemical Theory, Thought by Design. And this wonderful webinar is co-hosted by our guest speaker, Ms. Soha Juneja. So we heartily welcome you, ma'am, on behalf of whole AirQ's Aviation Private Limited Company. Now, over to you. Thank you.
A very good evening to everybody. Since the topic is about chemical theory and, you know, we are just having a half hour webinar, so I would love to quickly start the session. What is chemical theory all about? Why are we actually talking about chemical theory? In the sense, you know, there are a lot of webinars which are going on off late, and everybody is talking about, you know, the mental hack. Everybody is talking about why is that we are, you know, so much disturbed at this point in time of life. Reason could be many, but at this point in time, I feel that the reason is the COVID. Of course, that's how mental health had actually come into picture today, in today's era. And we are going to talk about the chemical theory of our brains. How does it actually happen and how does it help us, you know, go well or be well? So the wellness of our mind, you know, we've been given, we've been giving a lot of importance to, if I'm not wrong, our physical health. If I'm not wrong, you know, to probably give a food to the physical part of it. So we take care of the nutrition, we take care of our body, we take care of exercises, and so on and so forth. But what about our brain? Why is that we are not giving that much of importance to the brain and the health of our brain? I am sure, you know, there are a lot of times, because of a lot of issues and concerns happening around, we are mentally getting stressed. It could, the reasons could be many, as I said. So a lot of people keep talking about, you know, how are you feeling? A lot of people talk about you feeling unwell, but people forget to ask if you are okay. And we are going to tap into that particular part today. So I would rather use this word saying where to scratch. Yeah, where to scratch. It's not about scratching, you know, when some mosquito bites happen or some allergies. I'm talking about scratching your brain. Yes. So how do we, you know, talk about these mental hacks? What are the mental hacks all about? How do we focus upon the mental hacks? So how many of you, you know, in total feel that you're stressed in your life? You know, there is a lot of difference between stress, and then there is a lot of difference between anxiety. I would like to talk a little about that, and then we can continue the session. So stress can be temporary. Of course, it can actually also be very deviating. It can also be very disturbing. It can also be very, you know, what is it called? Mind, soul breaking. But then stress can also be temporary. We have, you know, so many types of stress and anxieties coming in today. We have around at least 19 types of different stress levels. So the first stress is where maybe you want to go and meet your friend and you're not able to meet that day. Or maybe in time. For example, if somebody is asking me to attend a training session or to give a training session, and if I'm not able to log in time, because of maybe some errors like my system's not working, or maybe it's not switching on, or maybe my internet is slow, I might actually get stressed out, and that's temporary. Or maybe for you, if you are maybe not allowed to go out, or maybe if you're not able to go out, or maybe you're reaching office late, or maybe you're reaching home late, or maybe somebody is calling, you're not able to pick up a call at that point in time, you might get stressed out. So these stresses are temporary. They are just temporary. You know, maybe somebody messages you on WhatsApp and you're not able to reply them in time and they get upset about it. So you get upset about that you were not able to reply back in time. That can also be temporary. So that is actually stress, which can be temporary and which can actually be permanent too. But then anxiety is something which is very, very concerning. Anxiety is something which is going to, you know, give you a lot of triggers. Stress, because it's temporary, it cannot lead to a very fatal, mental health. But anxiety can actually do that, because anxiety is something which is related to your thoughts. It can be permanent and it can be, you know, really, really hurting. Meaning it can actually give you a lot of, problems like sleepless nights. You might have issues with regards to your food intake. You might actually bloat up. You might go fat. You might go very thin. You might close yourself into a room. You might have suicidal thoughts. Yeah. So that is anxiety. And you need to reach out for help when you're in anxiety. Now, when we are talking about the mental hack, how do you hack your brain? So I will give you a little tip on that. Before I could give you a tip, I would also like to tell you something. You know, the competition today across the globe had grown so much that we are competing with one another. Before a few years, I mean, I would like to give you quote an example here. Before a few years, the competition was very, very less. So people were not, now it's like, you know, everybody is running one after the other. Everybody is really striving for making their living better. In that bargain, they are forgetting this part of being happy. I always tell everybody, you know, happiness is the state of mind when you're born. Happiness is your state of mind when you're born. But when you're growing, each day by day, what happens is that you're looking around the people who are maybe growing better. You feel that, maybe growing better. And that's what is hurting you more. So I would like to quote an example. As I said, you know, I'll talk about three little stories, or maybe I can actually tell you that this will show you where you or I stand together. So there was a friend. There were two friends, very, very close friends, both boys. Studied in the same school, you know, the typical chuddy buddy years. So they studied in the same school, grew up together, went to the same college, passed out the same year. And then while they were doing this, you know, their friendship was so thick that they never wanted to leave each other. You know, when we are young, when we are in teenage, we say, okay, we are the best of the buddies and we never leave each other. We will remain like this for our entire life. But time actually turns. You need to leave each other. You get married. Life changes. So they changed too. One had to go to America for his work and the other stayed back in India. So the American came back to India. And suddenly, while driving on the way, he saw his friend who was in India. And his friend was driving a Mercedes. So the one who came from foreign, the one who came from US, saw his friend driving Mercedes. He stopped his friend by, they both stopped, they parked their cars and they got down, they hugged each other, they started speaking to each other. But in their hearts, wo hota hai na man hi man mein, the other friend who came back from America started thinking for the other friend that he's so fortunate. Living in India, he could earn so much that he had bought a Mercedes. Whereas he was thinking for himself that I, living in America, coming back to India, settling down in India, could not fetch a lot of money. So I just have a Honda City. And he was feeling bad for himself. So he was indirectly trying to compete his abilities with his friends. Instead of being happy for his friend, he was actually feeling sad for himself. And he thought that my friend has a Merc. I do not have a Merc. I just have a Honda City. And my friend is very fortunate. Living in India, he is able to make so much money. But you know, I must tell you this. He forgot asking his friend whether he owned the Mercedes. Yeah, you're hearing me right. The friend who was actually having a Mercedes was a driver for the Mercedes. He was not the owner of the Mercedes. Look at the way we think. You know, we always think that they are the greener pastures the other side, but that's not the reality always. Now, the second one. So there was this lady, two good friends again, and both are girls this time. So one friend again, she was abroad for many, many years and she happened to turn up to India. She called her bestie and she said, let's catch up. And both of them caught up for a high tea. So one friend has had three children and the other had just one child. So the one who came from America had one child and the one who was in India had three children. They both spent very good time with each other. They, you know, loved that time. They had some snacks. The children really played well with each other. They became good friends, best of the friends again. And then the friend went back home from America and started thinking, how fortunate is my friend who is from India? How fortunate. She has three children. She has a complete package of a family. I just have one child. I'm not able to give birth to the other. How sad. My child doesn't have any other partner as a brother or sister. And especially, you know, this is in India. Ye hamare yahan hota hai ki one needs to have a partner, a child, a brother or a sister so that they take care after the parent. Yeah. So she was thinking on the same lines that my child is all by herself and, you know, she doesn't have any brothers or sisters. How will she lead her life in future? However, she forgot asking her friend whether the children who she was having were hers or not. So her friend, the one who was in India, adopted the two children she had with her, and the one child she had, who was her own child, was suffering from cancer. Now this is fate. And that's how people think about one another. And that's life. The third one, the last but not the least, and after that we shall continue. So the third one was about a woman and a man. That is a happily married couple, along with another happily married couple. So one couple started telling, one lady started telling her husband, you know, ladies are generally, we always compare our friends' husbands and we think they're so fortunate that the husbands are very caring and, you know, ours are like, oh God, though I'm very fortunate. Yeah. So one lady complains her husband, she tells you know what, you see Rosie and her husband. Her husband is so good. You know, whenever Rosie gets inside the car, gets out of the car, he opens the door of the car. You know, he allows Rosie to sit inside after hugging her. And he goes ahead and he sits on the driver's seat every single day. And when they reach back home, again, he does the same. He gets down of the car. He opens the door for Rosie. Rosie gets down. They hug each other and get inside the house. How fortunate, how loving, how affectionate. She's so fortunate that her husband is so affectionate. But in the bargain, she forgets to ask Rosie, what's the basic thing? Whether that was love towards her, that was respect towards her, that was affection towards her, or was it something else? The problem was that the door's handle from inside would never open. And that was the only reason that Rosie's husband would always open the door from outside. Yeah. So that was the reality. That was the reality. Imagine, what are we doing to ourselves? Of course, our competitions begins at home. Because, you know, most of the times, we live in a family where we are taught about usko dekho. Usse seekho. You know, we are always told about, why don't you learn from your brother? Why don't you learn from your sister? Why don't you learn from your neighbor? Why don't you learn from your friend? And that's how we are, you know, mentally fixed. And the chemical theories, which the chemical theory we are talking about, that's how it works also. That's how it works also. So whatever is told to you, you exactly do the same. You know, I keep telling this in every session of mine. Wherever I go, I give an exercise. I mean, I would be glad if people could actually get on the video for just a minute so that I will show you what a mental hack is and how does it actually happen in real. Yeah. Whoever are comfortable, if you can, turn on your videos, please. So I think we just have Rajeshwari, we just have Ashrita, who are on the video at this point in time. So this exercise is for you guys. What you could do is get your palms together. Get your palms together. Look at your palms. You will find one palm of yours, bigger than the other palm. You're able to see that? Yeah, everybody's. One palm is always bigger than the other palm. Are you able to see that? If you are able to see, say yes in the chat box. If you are able to see, say yes in the chat box. Great. So I have a chair. Okay, yes. Great. So now what you can do is again do the same thing. Get your palms together. Close your eyes. Tell yourself that your palms now are of equal size. Open your eyes and you will see they are of equal size. Attach again. Now you will see that they are of equal size. Are they? Give me a thumbs up if they are. Great. Yes. So this is a mental hack. You know, I'm just giving you one point like this. You have 100 points like this where I can show you that whatever you think here actually works on your body in real, on your mind in real, in your soul in real. So when you, you know, when I told you that one palm is certainly bigger, you immediately trusted on my words. Words make a huge impact. It makes a huge impact. All words. And when you listen time and again to people telling you can't, you can, you will try doing the same, try aping the same. And when we are born, from the time we are born to the time we grow, we hear the word N-O, no, at least 87,000 times. Imagine, what is the number? You're hearing it. Your mind is actually getting hacked by whom? By our own parent. You know, as a parent, we tell our children, no, you can't. And that's the reason you do not become an independent person. Most of the times we are mentally distracted because nobody is actually taught about how our mental health should be concerned. We are stressed out for small little things, reason being many. You get up in the morning and you rush to the school, you rush to the college, you rush to the office, right or wrong. One night before you start planning to make your lunch or your breakfast or your family's breakfast or so on and so forth. We women are tuned for one particular lifestyle and men are tuned for another particular lifestyle. A man has to earn the bread and butter and the woman is the one who is supposed to cook, make the bread and butter. And that's how we are mentally, you know, but then at the same time, most of the times when we are not feeling very healthy in the morning, we are not up to the mark in the morning, we are not feeling very energetic for the entire day. By the time we are waking up in the morning itself, our body is actually giving up. It's in a lot of pains. It's in a lot of stress. It's not able to actually be itself because there are so many other things moving in your head all the time. Reason? Number one, the nights are not very healthy before you sleep. And when you wake up with a lot of tension that you need to reach at one particular time, or maybe need to cook, or maybe need to, call, or maybe need to talk to somebody, or maybe there are 100 chores which you have to do for the day. And that's moving in your head all the time when you wake up. You get into the bathroom, you rush your bathing, and then you come out. Your bathing style will again affect your entire body, mind, and soul. How do you bathe? I am sure everybody bathes with their shoulders first. We put, and men especially, with the hair, head. They take the water or they get inside the bathroom and get below the shower. But that's absolutely wrong way of taking bath. You need to start with your feet. Most of the deaths, most of the attacks, most of the times the paralysis or the brain attacks or the heart attacks appear only after we take bath and we come out. That is wee hours, early mornings. Reason being that we take bath, especially men, they take bath with their head first. A very unhealthy way. So this is another hack. You need to start bathing with your feet first. You need to pour water on your feet and then on your legs, then on your thighs, and then on your shoulders, and then your head. Head is the last part. So when you start bathing like that, your health of your brain becomes more better. The memories, you know, as and when we are growing, our memories actually start fading away. There are very, very few elders you see that their memory is really very sharp. Otherwise, the memories fade away. Even ours at this age fade away. You know, we are not really able to. Sometimes we keep forgetting things and we are thinking, oh God, kaha bhul gaye hai, kaha rakh diya hai, kya kar diya hai, pata nahi mil nahi raha hai, all that. So that's only because of your bathing style. That's only because you bathe in a hurry. You just get into the washroom, you get ready. You just have to come out and either rush to your office or your daily chores. So that is your second mental hack. One is that the palms, you whatever you think in your brain, you can actually perceive and do it. And it is very much possible. I just showed it how. One small exercise. I can show you many, but I think we do have time constraints here. Second one was taking bath with your feet. Now third, how many of you here sitting in the room are right-handers? If you're right-handers, please write a right into the chat box. Yeah, great. Right-handers can write down right into the chat box. Left-handers can write left into the chat box. Great. So now since you're right-handers, I would suggest you should take, you should brush your tooth with your left hand. The right-handers are supposed to brush their tooth with their left hand. And the left-handers are supposed to brush their tooth with their right hands. And that's how it actually is supposed to be. That's how it's supposed to be. What will happen by this? Ma'am, you're telling we need to, you know, you're giving us hacks, but you need to give us reasons how. Like I had already given you a reason on bathing. I will also give you a reason on by brushing with your opposite direction, opposite side, what happens? You become more creative, number one. Your memories become very, very strong, number two. And these are all scientifically proven hacks. I am not telling just because I need to say, you can browse and you can find out. Anyways, we have our Google queen, the information technology age. We are living it. We are just a, you know, fingertip away for everything. Very much positive and a great generation actually today. Yeah. Because when we were young, you know, we did not have an option where we can actually Google anything and everything. All the information were never on tips. We had to literally go through, learn, and then, you know, get that gyan. But today the gyan is just a fingertip away. However, so the third mental hack is that you need to start brushing your tooth with your left if you're a righty. This increases your memory. This increases your the power of thinking. It makes you more creative and more lively. The fourth hack, whenever you feel I'm too much stressed out and I do not know how to, you're sitting on an office chair. You're sitting on an office chair. The only tip I can give you when you're feeling very much stressed out is your shoulder bones. You need to take your shoulder bones. Whenever you're stressed, you feel that you need a break. You feel that you need to, you know, take a break for maybe 2 minutes. You just need to relax. Maybe your boss has screamed at you. Maybe he is not very happy with your work. Maybe he is appreciating somebody else, but you're working really, really hard. And you're not understanding how do you convey. At that point in time, you're completely out of your head. At that point in time where you need to relax yourself and you need to pep up your mood and you need to feel better and happy, you can take the help of your shoulder bones. Of course, don't look at my bones. They are hardly seen because I'm very much on the healthier side. So what you can do is you can take the help of your shoulder bones. Just start pressing on your shoulder bones. Initially, when you do that, it'll hurt you a little. But never mind, even if it's hurting you, just do it for a few seconds. And automatically, the chemicals in your body, like, you know, we have a lot of chemicals in our body. Like we have serotonin, we have dopamine. These are the chemicals which makes you a happier person, a merrier person. So the dopamine levels actually goes up. Or maybe you're feeling, you know, I do not want to do this in office. You know, this is not really okay. Sitting at my desk and doing it, people might actually look at me and think, pata nahi kya chal raha hai, what is happening? What is she trying to do? So that point in time, you can maybe just have two bricks of dark chocolate. Buy a bar, keep it in your desk, break it, just take two bricks, pop it in, and you will feel much better and sorted. Much better and sorted. You will feel relaxed. Or maybe you want to probably, your eyes are really straining because, you know, you have so much of tension around. What you could do is you could do this. You know, you could start pressing your eyebrows exactly at the arrow shape here. And then you can start pressing it in the middle of your eyes here. You all can try it right away. You can find the difference. You can start pressing this. You can start pressing this area. You can start pressing this area. You can start pressing this area. Or the fifth hack is that you can start tapping. You know, you can start tapping here. You can start tapping here. The first one is the middle here. And then on the cheekbones. Then on the chin. Above here. So these are the parts you can actually start tapping. And you need to tap for a few seconds. Okay, start tapping for a few seconds and you will feel very much relaxed. Very much relaxed. You can also say, ma'am, you are talking about, you know, how do we mentally hack ourselves? You're talking about being a merrier person. You're talking about being a happier person. You're talking about being a sorted person. You're talking about giving ourselves a relaxation mode. You know, there is always a version. There is always a mode that you can switch yourself on and off to. So the switching off mode is when, ma'am, at night, I'm not able to sleep because of the stress. I am feeling very uncomfortable because, you know, there is so much of trauma around me. I am very much uncomfortable because I feel that things are not happening my way and I'm not able to sleep. I have sleepless nights and that's the reason I'm not able to get up healthy in the morning. I'm not able to get up. I'm not pepped up in the morning to get up and go to my work. Whenever there is work, I feel, oh my God, do I have to really go to office today? I need to take a break. I don't feel like pushing myself to office. Now, at that point in time, you have a bone behind your ear here. You need to press the bone. You need to press the bone constantly. And when you do that at night, do it at night, not in the day. Do it at night. When you do it at night, you will immediately fall asleep. You will immediately fall asleep. Few seconds. You can go to my LinkedIn profile. You will see there are a lot of people who had given me feedback after the sessions and they really felt sleepy and they went off to sleep. So these are all proven exercises, guys. I'm just not telling for the heck of it and so that you can, you know, see this is a session and we need to end it this way. Not at all. These are all proven ones and you can try them out. So that is another tip you can do. So, but then when you feel that apart from all these tips also, I am not still okay. That's when you need to reach to a mental health architect. That's when you need to reach to one particular person. As I said, when you start pressing this part, you will feel sleepy and you will feel relaxed. When you want to pep up your mood, you need to just do the tapping exercises, the cheekbones. This will help you enhance your mood. This will help you enhance your soul. As I told you, that you need to, you know, hack your mind by brushing your tooth with your left if you are a right-hander. And start brushing your tooth with your right hand if you are a left-hander. So these are few hacks which can be applied. This is a chemical theory which will actually work on your brain, your body, your soul. Of course, I tell that you need to get up in the morning. You need to have a regime. You need to go for an exercise. Physical health is your wealth. Ma'am, whatever you're telling, you know, we already know about all these things that if you actually physically work out, you stay fit and healthy. But then I don't have the motivation to do so. I'm not able to get up in the morning because I don't have that push. Itna stress rehta hai. You know, saying is easier, but doing is difficult. Ma'am, you're very easily saying it. You know, you just do it and you'll be fine. But how many attempts I do to keep myself happy, I still have a lot of tensions around me. Most of us do not tell it. And most of us keep nagging over it. It's you know, there is, of course, a proverb saying it's easier said than done. But trust me, 5 minutes for yourself, it's called me time. very important. I feel frustrated at times. I do not know. I'm so frustrated on my boss that sometimes I feel like, I don't know if your boss is somewhere here, sitting in this room. But then, ma'am, I'm not very happy about it. What do I do? How do I go about it? In spite of doing everything, I'm still not able to sort. That's when you need to talk to somebody. And it is okay to be frustrated at times. As I said, stress is temporary. It would only be temporary. But only when you have a thought that I need to sit into the room, I do not want to come out, I am binge eating or I'm not at all eating, is when I need to reach out to people who can help me out. Supposedly, you do not want to go to a mental health architect because they might charge you. But for many, first few sessions are also complimentary. So you might reach out to such people. You can see if they are worth talking to. And if you feel that, yes, I need to reach out to this person, and then this person can actually help me, groom or feel better, then you can reach out to them. Maybe you can reach out to me. I would give it a complimentary session too. But then you should reach out to people. If you are feeling that they are chargeable, they're charging you, you can reach out to your friends, your family, your mentors, or whoever you are comfortable with. You feel that, okay, fine, they will not judge me. You can talk to them. You can reach out to them. So I would like to tell everybody here who are in this room today that you need to reach out in case you feel that you need to shut your doors and sit inside the doors. You need to voice out. And it is okay many a times not to be okay. You know, I always tell this two statements whenever I've been taking sessions. One, number one is that it is okay not to be okay. And number two is that it is not okay not to be okay. Ma'am, you're contradicting your own statements. You know, I mean, what is it? The first go, you're saying it's okay not to be okay. Then you're saying it's not okay not to be okay. I will give you an example. Why am I saying this? It is okay not to be okay because if the stress is temporary, for example, I was not able to go out tonight. I wanted to go for dinner. It is okay that you were not able to go out for that point in time. Your friend is not talking to you, so you feel disgusted about it. Or your partner is upset upon you, so you're not very happy about it. So it is okay not to be okay for that point in time because it's temporary again. Ma'am, I probably wanted to go out and buy a dress for myself. I could not. It is okay to be upset for that point in time. Why is it not okay not to be okay? Is when you want to shut your doors on yourself. Is when you want to cry into a room and tell yourself that, okay, I'm not feeling okay. Many a times if you want to cry it over, many a times if you want to cry ourselves and just shut the doors and not come out for a lot of time. That is when your concern is triggering. That is when it's alarming, when you want to shut the doors. You get into binge eating because you're not feeling that well. That is when you need to reach out. It's alarming. You want to sleep for hours together. Sleeping for 8 hours a day or 9 hours to the maximum is good. But if you're exceeding the sleeping hours, it's very dangerous. And if you're reducing the sleeping hours, for example, if you're just sleeping in for 5 hours or 4 hours, or not at all good. Until you're completely fit and healthy. If you're completely energetic, even after 4 hours of sleep and proper sleep, then it's absolutely fine. But I know you will have a lot of breaks while you're sleeping. You wake up for washroom, you wake up for many reasons. And that's not very healthy. When you want to probably shut the doors and you have suicidal thoughts, it's not okay. Many of us in this room, I'm sure, might have at least once in their lifetime thought of attempting or thought of like, why am I living on the face of this God's green earth? At least I had that time. Many of you might have had it. And if that is the case, you need to reach out. You need to talk. Talking is the only solution to all your problems. Talk it out with your friends. Talk it out with the people whom you can rely upon, whom you trust completely, whom you know that they will not judge you. Rather, they will actually support you, take you into the arms, hold you back and tell that we are there for you. I have such thoughts. I also reach out to people, trust me. So it's like the elephant syndrome. I would, like to you know, give this example before I complete the session of an elephant. When the elephant is actually born, if you look at the elephants into the zoo and circus, I'm sure many of us might have seen elephants in zoo and circus. I'm not talking about the elephants in the forest, not at all. I'm talking about it in the zoo and the circus. So when the elephants are born, they are left open, completely open. And you know, because they're left open, elephants are left open, they actually create a lot of ruckus. They create a lot of mess around because they're moving here and there. They're running here and there. They're jumping here and there. And they are left all open. And suddenly after 6 months of the elephant is born, the elephant is actually chained onto a pillar. A very, very thick pillar, a cemented pillar with a huge chain. The 6 month old elephant is actually chained. What happens with that particular pillar or that elephant is, the elephant actually tries to pull the chain for almost 6 months. 6 months to a year. It's growing now. The elephant is actually growing bigger. And it's trying to pull the chain because it was not chained when it was born. It was chained after 6 months of its liberty, of its freedom, and suddenly caged. It will not like it. So it tries to break the chain. It tries to pull it back. It tries to drag it back. Very unfortunately, it hurts its feet. It starts bleeding. And it's trying its best, real best, but it isn't really happening. It isn't really happening. It's just pulling the chain over. It's hurting its feet. Now, it tried it, but it did not really break the chain because the chain was heavier than the elephant. The pillar was stronger than the elephant. Now, after a year, it starts hitting its trunk onto the pillar, but it's still not able to. It's still not able to. Unfortunately, after, in spite of doing all this also, it's not able to free itself. So it gives up. It's exactly with all of us. We are sitting in the room here. It's exactly with all of us. The people who are listening to us, the people who are hearing us out, this is for every single person. That's how we mentally hack ourselves. That's the you know, bonding we have with the world, with the people around us, with the relatives, with the society, with our family. And then we look at us, you know, I mean, for the very first time from your college, you wanted to go out of your college. The permissions were granted by your parents because it was the first time you wanted to venture out. And later, you were completely closed. Later, you were completely closed. For the first few days, you were sent to your friend's house to their birthday parties. And suddenly, you were told not to go. What happens? All the melodrama begins. Because till this point in time, you were absolutely free. You were sent to every friend's birthday and suddenly they asked you not to go. What will happen? You will not be very comfortable with it. You will, you know, stop on your comfort zone. You will start being uncomfortable because you're not allowed. The same thing happened with the baby elephant. Now it was chained and it wasn't allowed. So it tried using its trunk. It tried for almost 1 year. After that 1 year, it started growing bigger, heavier and huge, not only on its size, but overall in its body, overall in its weight. But now the elephant is only tied in the zoo and also in the circus just with a rope on a normal bamboo stick. But the elephant doesn't move from there. It just moves, you know, front and behind, sidewise also, because now it's tuned its mind that it cannot break the chain. Whereas now it's no more a chain, it's just a rope. If it wants, it can just, you know, push or force itself a little and everything is sorted. It can actually run away, but it doesn't because that's how it's mentally fixed. And the same thing happens with us. You know, when we are born with a mindset. When we are growing with another mindset. And when we grow old, we are grown old with another mindset. And we are continuing to do that. So the sixth mental hack is that you need to start living in an uncomfort zone. Break your norms every single day. According to Charles Darwin, growth happens only in uncomfort zone. Growth happens only in uncomfort zone. It never happens in comfort zone. So you need to start living in uncomfort zone. in order to have that particular growth coming in your way. If you think you want to change your life, you can. It's in your hands. Every single morning, if I get up and I do the same ritual, expecting different results, cannot happen. Ma'am, you know what? I've seen the people who are happier become more happier and merrier. The people who are sad becomes more sad. Yeah, we actually give this example for money, but I'm talking about the happier and a merrier part of life. The people who are happier every single day, try doing something new, try experimenting something new. Do we experiment something new? The chair we are sitting on and we are comfortable, we want to sit on the same chair. The bed we used to sleep, we lie down in one particular corner, we only sleep in that particular pattern. We wake up, we go to our office at 7:30 every morning, we will go at 7:30 every morning. We open our systems and we do one particular work every single morning and we do that one particular work every single morning. So there is no change. And then you're expecting different results. You are living in a comfort zone and you're telling that you want to probably do something very miraculous in your life. It isn't really possible. So your mental hacks is that when you get up in the morning, you need to start with your bath. You need to remember that in your head. You know, your mental hack is so important. It is so workable. It gives you miracles. Like, you know, if you want to get up at 5 in the morning, you just sleep on your pillow, tap on your pillow five times and say that you want to get up, wake up at 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Tell your brain that you want to get up at 5. You will get up at 5. Try this experiment. And if it doesn't work out, contact me. You know, Shekharji has my number. You can always reach him out and he will let you know my number or my contact details. Or you can reach me at Soha Juneja Facebook. Or you can also reach me at Soha J LinkedIn. And you will be able to see these things which are actually working in your life. And how do we mentally hack ourselves? How do we improve ourselves? How do we improve our mental health? The last hack, but not the least. And after that, I will leave some questions to you if you have any questions to ask me. So the last hack is, whenever you feel that you're stressed out, whenever you feel that you're not very happy, whenever you feel that you need to make a change, whenever you feel that you need to probably at that point in time come out of some sort of a tension, start clapping. And you need to, you should not clap like this. You know, I know this is style. We clap, we generally clap like this or we clap like that. But then you need to clap like this. Yeah, keeping your palms straight and then clap. The acupressure points in your palms, all the acupressure points in your palms actually releases dopamines. It releases your stress. Your bloodstream runs really well. You will be much more relaxed. You will feel much more happier, merrier. You will feel much more easy. And you will also feel much more healthy. Whatever sort of concerns you have, like you have BP, you have diabetes, you have there are many other health issues. I do not want to name a lot of them, but then I think I will talk about the most common ones, that is BP and sugar. At least that would reduce and you will feel much better. So with this particular hack, I think I end my session. Thank you so much. So now I keep it open for your questions if you have any. I think Ashrita has some questions for you.
No, madam. Because someone came. I went outside.
So okay. That's okay. That's fine. Rajeshwari, it was an amazing session. Thank you so much. Thank you, Rajeshwari.
Thank you, ma'am.
Any questions with regards to your routine concerns? So I think there are no questions coming in. Shreya Joshi, it was a really good session and helpful. Thank you so much, Naina. I would be glad if, you know, people would actually come on and come on the video so that at least we can see each other for a time, for a moment. Yeah, that's good. So I'm able to see Sakshi now. Rajeshwari is on. You know, basically, I've heard from one of my beloved friends that whenever you put a mask and go in front of anybody and give an interview, how does it actually look? If you put a mask on your face, sit in front of somebody and give an interview, how does it look? Does it look very appealing? So when we have video calls, that's a basic norm that we need to actually be on the videos.
Yes,
I understand that many of us might be sitting in, you know, our own casual dresses, or we are very casual at this point in time. But then if you could come, that would have really, really been great. Never mind. Okay. Selva Murugan says, very helpful, ma'am, and attended a few minutes back. It's motivated me a lot. Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm really very glad that you people really love the session. All right.
Sakshi?
Yes, sir. I would express my sincere thanks to Ms. Soha Juneja. It was a pleasure to listen to you, ma'am. It was wonderful and amazing session. And I hope and I am sure that all have gained some insights from this webinar that how we overcome from stress through different exercises. So thank you a lot, ma'am, for giving your valuable time to us. Thank you again on behalf of whole ALQ's Aviation Private Limited Company.
Thank you so much. Thanks a lot.